Tonight we're learning halachot Yalkut Yosef, halachot of Rosh Hashanah, seder kriyat haTorah, the order of reading of the Torah on Rosh Hashanah. And omrim halel be Rosh Hashanah. On Rosh Hashanah we don't say halel, and also as well as Yom Kippurim. Lefish hem yamim noraim, because these are the days of yamim noraim, the days of fear. ויראו פחד ונועד לשובה ונועדו לשובה, and there is fear and of the teshuva, of the repentance. So there is no time to say halel. There is no, you can't really praise Hashem when you have so much fear. ולא ימי שמחה יתרה, and it's not the days of extra happiness. אבל אין צריך לדלג halel כש Korea Piragim Ele Bedere Kerya Keriato Betainim. But if somebody is reading Tehilim and there are the sections of the same Pesukim of the Halel in the Tehilim, one does not need to skip it. Don't skip it, just continue reading. Halakha Bet Yesh Lehizaher Be'et Mechirat Hamisbot Petichat Echad הקמת ספר תורה, העליות, שלא ישיח שיחה בטלה. One needs to be careful that when in Beit HaKnesset, the auctioning of the different mitzvot, like opening of the ark, the ספר תורה, the bringing out of the ספר תורה, ההגבהה, or the עליות of the Torah, right? One needs to be careful that in that time, he should not waste his time talking to his friend next to him. It's good to grab a sefer, study it, or say tehilim in between of that time. ומן הראוי שהגבאים האחרים לא יאריכו להכביד על הציבור במכירת המצוות בזמן ממושך ביום הקודש הזה. And also, the chazanim, they need to be careful. They need to watch out, right? Not to prolong so much the process of auctioning off. They need to do it as fast as they can to save time. Halacha gimel mutar limchor ha'aliyot b'shabbat b'chag ve'en bazeh mishum isur mekach u'memchad. There is no problem of selling aliyot for the sake of the mitzvot on Shabbat and Yom Tov and Chag. There is no problem of making business. וכן מותר לערוך מגבעות בימים הנוראים ובשאר שבתות לטובת מוסדות תורה וישיבות קדושות שהכל לצורך מצווהם. And also, one is allowed to collect money for yeshivot, for different causes, for different needy people, because they are all considered mitzvot, and it's not actually making business in Beit HaKnesset. It's actually the big mitzvah of Ve'ahavta le'racha kamocha. Be'et petichat ha'echal, in the time of opening of the Hechal Ark, Yesh Linhogo Lomar Yud Gimel Midot Betame Hamigra Gimel Palmin. There are those who have the minhag to say the 13 Midot of Rachamim, of Hashem's kindness, when three times. Veyesh Mefakfechim Al Ze She'en Lomar Yud Gimel Midot Beyom Tov. And there are those who don't actually say this section. It's better not to say it. Aval biyom kippurim omrim bepetichat hechal shalosh ese midot shalosh pamim. But on Yom Kippur, one should say the 13 midot of rachamim three times. Halacha he biyom harishon shel Rosh Hashanah. Orim betorah beparashat vayera On the first day of Rosh Hashanah, we say the Parashat Avayera. Hashem Parat et Sarah, which is the section that Hashem remembered Sarah. ומפטירין בפרשת פנחס, and they say the מפטיר of the פרשת פנחס, ובחודש השביעי באחד לחודש, which is the section of the seventh month, the first day of the חודש, וההפטרה בשמואל א', that's the הפטרה of שמואל א', that we say the הפטרה of the section of שמואל א', והיא איש אחד מן ארמתיים בעניין, Pekidata Shel Chana, which talks about the Chana, that Chana reached out to Hashem, right, for having children, right. Ad Vayaram Geren Meshicho Ki Shetehen Sarah VeChana Nifkedu BeRosh Hashanah, because the connection of these parshiot is that both Sarah and Chana, the tefillot were answered on Rosh Hashanah, and that they need not have children, so Hashem granted them children, Sarah and Chana. Kedeita berosh, amen. Kedeita berosh Hashanah, as it is mentioned in Masechet Rosh Hashanah, Daf Yud Amud Bet, ubeshaat petichat haichal yomeru yehi Hashem Elokeinu imanu ubeshavat matchilim ata haraat ledaat anan shabbat vi. Start with Atarata, and other days we say Yehi Hashem Elokeinu Imanu, right? Ubishat Petichat Echad Vechen Yomeru Berich Sheme, and also we say Berich Sheme. Yud Bet Pa'amim Leolam Hashem Devaracha Nisa Bashamayim Im Yehi Rason Shemiyuchad Rosh Hashanah. So we say 12 times. Right? Leolam Hashem Devaracha Nisa Bashamayim with the Yehi Rason afterwards. Afterwards, Yehi Rason that is exclusively for Rosh Hashanah. Halacha Vav. Beyom Hasheni Shel Rosh Hashanah Korim BeTorah BeParashat VaYera. On the second day of Rosh Hashanah, we read the Parashat VaYera. Inyan Agedat Yitzchak. We read the section of Agedat Yitzchak. Va'maftir Qore beParashat Pinchas, and the Maftir we say of the Parashat Pinchas, ubechodesh haShevi'i beEchad leChodesh. That's the section we say. Va'maftir beYirmiya, Masachen beMidbar, Masachen beMidbar, Ad Haben Yakil lo Ephraim. So that's the sections of the Haftarah and Mafti that we say. Halacha Zayin. Chovat hayom bechol yom tov chamisha gavarei hakorim betorah. The obligation of reading from Torah is five aliyot, five men, right, that they read from Torah, five aliyot. Ve'im chal b'shabbat sheva. And if it falls on Shabbat, right, then it's seven. Right, seven aliyot. Umutal lehosif beyom tov kama olim nosefim. And it is mutar to add a little more aliyot on yom tov. Ach lo yirbu yoter midai mishom torach sibur. But on yom tov, one should not add too much of aliyot, because that is the tirchas de sibura that causes tirchas sibura or torach sibur, that sibur wanna go home, they haven't said kiddush, they're tired, so why should you keep them for extra people to say blessings? Okay, halacha chet nachon meod shekol adam yireh Hashem ishtadel שתהיה לו עלייה לספר תורה באחד מן הימים הנוראים. It is very good, very appropriate that every person who is God-fearing to try to at least have one Aliyah Torah, one time he should say Birkat Torah by the Sefer Torah, In one of the days of Hayamim Noraim, so Yamim Noraim starts from, I believe, from Rosh Chodesh Elul, right, till all the way after Simchat Torah. ואף במקומות שנוהגים למכור המספות יקנה בדמים יקרים עלה לספר תורה. And even if in places where they auction off, go buy with the precious money, go buy this precious mitzvah of Aliyat Torah. ובפרט בבתי הכנסת שנוהגים להעביר מרבית כספי התרומות לישיבות חדושות שעליהם נאמר אס חיים היא למחזיקים בה ותומכה מאושר. Especially in the ישיבות that they accept תרומות, right, for the yeshiva, they accept payments for yeshiva for different.
They don't accept.
Shen machzikim.
They support.
Right. That.
They collect money so they.
So that's
support.
What it is. Right? They accept money. I mean, in other words, if people are wanna get aliyah, they need to say this much. We're gonna donate,
exactly.
And that's how they get the mitzvah of aliyah Torah. Halacha tet. נוהגים להשליח סיבור והתוכה עולים לספר תורה בימים הנוראים. It is the minhag of the shaliach sibur to call upon those who come to read from the Torah. ואף על פי שאין חובה בזה, even though that there is no obligation on this, and there was not everyone is obligated, מכיוון שמקבלים שכר על כך, since these gabayim are accepting sechar payment for this. Mikol magom mehiyot tov sheyalu lesefer Torah bichlal haolim hanusafim hanusafim. So additionally, you know, call upon the shaliach sibur, call upon the gabay sedaga to say bikat Torah. That's the way of appreciating what they do. Halacha yud asul lis'od se'udat qeva shel achilat pat yoter mekebesa lifnei tekiyat shofar. It is prohibited to have a meal of bread, more than 50 grams of bread, which is kebesa, before hearing of shofar. ולפני תפילת מוסר, and before תפילת מוסר. אבל תאימה, but tasting something, כגון תאימה של פירות, a little bit of having some fruits, מותרת ללא כל הגבלה של שיעור, as long as it's not too much. וכן אכילת פת, also eating of the bread, אפילו בנתינת ידיים, even though if somebody is washing for bread, or ברכת המוציא וברכת המזון, and that he is going to say ברכת המוציא and המזון, פחות מכבסה, less than כבסה, it's permissible, just less than 50 grams.
Okay.
Right. וגם השליח ציבור והתוקע רשאים לנהוג כן. And also shaliach sibur, and one who blows the shofar is also within this category. In other words, if they need to eat something to have some energy, with the instructions that we gave, we explained, they can do it. Halacha yud alef togea שמוכרח לאכול לפני שיתקעה בשופר. יש מי שכתוב שחייב לקדש על הכוס לפני שיוכל. A person who is going to blow shofar, before blowing of shofar, there are those who say that he is obligated to say kiddush on wine before he eats. ויש אומרים שלא Chala Chovat Kiddush Ela La'acha Tefilat Musa. And those halachic authorities that they say that he is not really obligated to say Kiddush, the obligation of saying Kiddush comes after Tefilat Musa. ולמעשה עדיף שיחדש על היין קודם שיוכל. But the halacha למעשה, in actual halacha, the correct halacha is that if he wants to eat, right, he must say chidush before he eats. ויתאם כמלא לוגמו בלבד. And he needs to have a cheek full of wine or grape juice. ויחזור ויחדש על יין after Tefillat Musaf, so he should go back and say another Kiddush after Tefillat Musaf, lifnei sheis udo, sheis od bebeto, before he has the actual seuda at home. Uma sheyesh noagim shechol hasibur mekadeshim veochlim lifnei tehiyat shofar, en minhag ze ole yafe, uminhag hasefardim shelo lit. And those who have the minhag, that before blowing of shofar, they go and they eat, they have kiddush, they eat a little bit, that's not a good minhag. Sephardim do not have such a minhag. Sephardim do not eat till they blow the shofar, they hear the shofar. Until the end of after the Musaf and all that, right? Achar halacha yud bet, achar kiryat haTorah, Omer hamaftir kaddish. After reading of the Torah, the one who reads the maftir, it says kaddish. Ve'im shachach hamaftir lomar kaddish achar kiryat haTorah. And if the person who read the maftir, he forgot to say Kaddish after reading of the Torah. And he started reading of the Berachot of Haftarah. And he hears that the members of the Beit HaKnesset are complaining. They're shouting at him, Kaddish, Kaddish. Right? He'd palbel be'amar Kaddish ben. ברכות הפטרו להפטרה יש אומרים שצריך לחזור ולברך שוב את ברכות הפטרה. So he got mixed up, he got all worried, and he said Kaddish in the middle of the blessings. There are those who say that he needs to go back and repeat all the blessings of הפטרה.
So he has to read הפטרה again?
He hasn't started, he was reading. Right, he was reading the blessings of the Haftarah. First is Maftir, after Maftir is Kaddish, after Kaddish is the blessings of Haftarah. Right? Ve'yesh omrim shekol shehafsik bedevarim shebekedusha bedi'eved eino hafsik. And there are those who say that if a person interrupted in between the blessings of Haftarah, right, and what he did was mitzvah, that's not really considered hefsek, that's not an interruption. So the halakha lemaase is that he should go back and repeat all the blessings of haftarah. Halakha yud gimel. Achar haftarah omrim hapiyot et sha'rei rason. After haftarah, we say the song of et sha'rei rason. Achzir, Agedato shel Yitzchak Avinu. Please remember the Agedat Yitzchak, right? And the same have Rachamim and Mercy on us. Halacha Yud Dalet. Im yesh brit mila berosh Hashana, malin ben qiriyat haTorah letaqiyat shofar. If there is brit mila on the night of on the day of Rosh Hashanah, they should have the Brit Milah in between reading of the Torah and the Tehillat Shofar. And that was right after Torah reading is done, before Tehiyat Shofar, blowing of the Shofar. Ve'yesh shenhog she'im shenahagu, sorry. Ve'yesh shenahagu she'im hamohel hu ha'toghea eino meganeach et piv achar hamila. And there are those who have the minhag, that if the minhag, they have the minhag, that the one who blows the shofar also is the mohel, right? So the mohel that had the brit mila, he would not wipe his lips, right? And with the lips that he did the mesisat dam, that he squeezed out that little bit of dam, he should go ahead and immediately use that very lips which has some blood on it. La'arev mispat mila b'shofar, to connect or to mix together the mitzvah of mila, brit mila, with the shofar. So that way, that he should do it. Baruch Adonai le'olam, amen, amen.